Women being the minority in the entire prison population, while we are working in the various correctional homes in India, we see that in most of the cases, in most of the correctional homes, their specific needs and requirements are not met and are violated. Most of the prisons, most of the correctional homes, their infrastructure, their facilities are best suited to the male requirements, to the male inmates. Women being, say, special, women being vulnerable, their needs and requirements cannot be equated with those of the male prisoners. We cannot say that the issues of medical facilities or medical requirements with respect to the male inmates is equal to those of the female prisoners. We cannot say their privacy requirements can be equated to that of the male prisoners. We cannot say that when it comes to segregation, the seriousness or the effectiveness is equivalent to those of the male inmates. And especially when the women prisoners are, many of the women prisoners are staying in the correctional homes with their children, their vulnerability and their victimization when their rights are violated or when their needs are not fulfilled becomes all the more serious. So in this session, we would try to identify, we would try to discuss, we would try to deliberate on the various issues which the women prisoners are facing in the various correctional homes in India. First, we will be discussing how the various courts in India till date have dealt with the various issues, which are the issues they have identified and how they have addressed, whether they have been effective enough to address all the issues in the right way. It is up to you to suggest the discussion round. Then we will go to our respective speakers. We have Sharusha Gupta Khan, from advocate from HRL and MP. We have Meena Kumari. We have Meena Ji, who is an advocate in Rajasthan. And we have Devrani Ji, who is a senior advocate, a senior member of HRL from Bihar. They would be discussing the specific cases, the specific violations which have occurred in their respective states with respect to the women prisoners, how they have dealt with through their various court interventions or through advocacy. Before that, I would like to share with you the various Supreme Court judgments as well as the various High Court judgments where the courts have till date dealt with the various issues of the women prisoners. And lastly, we will be discussing with respect to this public interest litigation, which we planned in the last national consultation in April, that we will be filing in the Supreme Court. We will be discussing on that. It is ready to be drafted, it is ready to be filed, but the only problem is that we could get information only with respect to West Bengal and Madhya Pradesh. Despite a repetitive requesting to all state units, we could not get information. So now, since all of you are here, this is the best platform to catch you all and get all the information. So at the end, before the open discussion, we will be discussing on the public interest litigation. First, in this presentation, I have tried to identify the common issues faced by women in the various correctional homes in India. First, major and manifest issues which I feel is most, almost all the correctional homes in India are facing is overcrowding. In West Bengal, most of our correctional homes are overcrowded with people, with the foreign inmates, people who are arrested under the Foreigners Act. Even though they have completed their period of conviction, they are languishing in the jails for years. This leads to a lot of problems. This leads to problem of segregation. This leads to problem of hygiene. This leads to problem of medical facilities, lack of water supply, nutritional, and also it also leads to the breeding. It also leads to the correctional homes being the breeding grounds of various diseases. So overcrowding is one of the major issues. Second is inappropriate staffing, especially female staffing. The utmost requirement when it comes to female security in the women's correctional homes is that they should be provided with women officers, women guards. But we have seen in many of the correctional homes that women staffs or guards are not adequate. Male officers enter the female enclosures without informing them, without giving them prior information. Next is lack of family contact. This is the problem which is manifest, especially with respect to mentally ill women prisoners. We generally police find mentally ill prisoners from locations, and because of their mental state, they cannot really locate or cannot really tell about their residential address or where they belong from. So many of the cases we feel that the responsibility from the correction home officers is more to be proactive with respect to tracing their family. They should refer these cases to the legal aid lawyers. They should refer these cases to the other voluntary organization lawyers so that adequate intervention is taken. So lack of family contact is a very big problem, especially with respect to mentally ill legal prisoners, women prisoners. Lack of education and employment programs. Rehabilitation should not be an issue after the prisoner is released from the prison. It should be an issue which should be dealt with when the prisoner is there within the prison. So the proper rehabilitation program with respect to their education, with respect to their employment should be properly dealt with so that as and when they get released, they can enter the mainstream of the society. Lack of proper health care for women, especially with respect to pregnant and lactating mothers. This is a very, very serious issue, and the situation is very grim in most of the correctional homes in India. Medical facilities are not adequate. As I say, the facilities are always suitable for the male inmates. So a registered medical officer who is visiting the male inmates, they are also visiting the female inmates. The correctional home, the government does not feel the need that there should be a pediatrician because there are children in the women correctional home. There has to be a gynecologist. They do not feel the need. So there is lack of proper healthcare for women, and pregnant and lactating mothers do not get the adequate nutritional requirement and proper medical checkup. Facilities for the proper growth and development of the children within the prison. Till 6 years, the children are supposed to live with their mothers in the prison. And when children till 6 years are living with their prison, it is important that their health is taken care of, their vaccination is taken care of, their food and clothing is taken care of. But and very importantly, they should always be segregated from the other prisoners because it is very detrimental to their growth and development. Nothing like that happens in most of the correctional homes. Pre-legal aid that we have discussed in the last session, I do not think it needs to be explained further. That is a very important issue, especially with respect to women prisoners. Now I come to the important judgments. First is Sheila versus State of Maharashtra. In this case, the issue of legal aid has been dealt with very seriously. The legal aid har ek prisoner ko at the time of first production provide karna padega. Magistrate ki ye duty hai ki wo se inform kare prisoner ko ki he has the right to have a lawyer. He has the right to have a legal. In case he cannot afford a lawyer, he has the right to the state will provide him with a lawyer. After every 48 hours, he has to be medically re-examined, and if any physical torture has been inflicted on him, that also has to be inquired by the magistrate after on every production. So in case mein bola ja raha hai, every arrest should be intimated to the legal aid committee so that legal aid lawyer is immediately provided if needed. Details relating to undertrials must be sent to the legal aid committee with separate details in respect of men and women. Details were to be published about prisoners arrested on suspicion under Section 41 of the CRPC and also in respect of those who were in jail for more than 15 days. इसमें मैं एक ऐड करना चाहती हूँ जो मैंने पहले सेशन में बोला था. No, there is no charge there. हाँ इस पॉइंट पे मैं बोलना चाहती हूँ कि जो पहले सेशन में मैंने बोला था कि वेस्ट बंगाल में एक इशू है वेयर सेक्शन 107 और 109 में के केसेस में जिनको अरेस्ट किया जाता है उनको जेल में डाल दिया जाता है. तो शीला वर्सेस में सेक्शन 41 को बोला गया है क्योंकि सेक्शन 107 और 109 के केसेस का भी एक ट्रैक रखना चाहिए कि एग्जीक्यूटिव मैजिस्ट्रेट उन सब अधिकारी उन सब अक्यूज पर्सन को कभी भी जेल में ना डाले. दैट